Our God is an awesome God. God is dealing with His people and the world around us. His desire is to see all people saved. Does that sound far-fetched? In our finite minds, we may think so, but with God, all things are possible. Matthew 19:26, ESV. How would our lives be different if we all lived like we truly believed that? Jesus said, "The harvest is plentiful, but the laborers are few." Matthew 9:37, ESV. This, of course, means that there are so many in the world that are searching for something or someone who can fill that void in their lives. And, if given the opportunity, would turn their eyes toward heaven and accept Jesus as their personal Savior. It would then become our responsibility, through discipleship, to show Jesus as the light that shines through the darkness and brings the lost to Him. Jesus said, "I am the light of the world. Whoever follows me will not walk in darkness, but will have the light of life." John 8:12, ESV. There are many folks that we come in contact with daily that are spiritually lost and separated from the unseen realm of God, and are in dire need of hope for true life and a Savior. But they are completely unaware of their spiritual condition. Probably few, if any, have shown them love or even just a modicum of respect, which makes them hard of heart and causes them to turn a deaf ear to what they see as religious speak and without love, the Apostle Paul said. How then will they call on Him in whom they have not believed? And how are they to believe on Him of whom they have never heard? And how are they to hear without someone preaching? Romans 10:14, ESV. What we as believers must do is not only show the person love, but patience and respect. Some people become angry when presented with the gospel due to their feeling of guilt, that is when the presenter must remain calm and show love, and that the person is not being judged, but is being shown how to be allowed to enter the kingdom of God. I know that's not easy sometimes, but it is essential. Every man, woman and child, at the age of accountability, has the right to be provided with the truth of who Jesus is. This gives them the means to make the choice, and it is a choice to decide whether to receive Jesus as Savior or not. We must find a way to lovingly show that Jesus is calling all people to Him as He said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many rooms. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself, that where I am, you may be also." John 14:1-3. ESV. For anyone to get there, a person must receive Jesus as Savior, because He is the only way to heaven. "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." John 14:6, ESV. Whether or not the person chooses to receive Him as Savior at the time you are witnessing, you have planted the seed of the gospel. It then becomes an opportunity for another to water that seed, and then allow the Holy Spirit to make it sprout and grow in the heart, melting that hardness until the individual sees the need for a Savior and receives Him. For those hearing this message, I am trying to convey, through the very words of Jesus, that if you have never believed in Jesus as the only begotten Son of the one true God of the universe, and asked Him into your heart, you are not saved from the eternal death that awaits all of the unsaved. You may have heard some of the revered media folks say things like, "There are many ways to reach heaven," or "Multiple religions can get you into the afterlife in the presence of whatever deity you believe in." But understand, there is only one God, and there is, as previously stated, only one way to the Father. All other statements to the contrary are nothing but lies initiated by Satan himself. If you are in a place of desperation in your life or just searching, Jesus is the answer. I've heard people ask, in a somewhat joking manner, "Well, what is the question?" To which I just say, it doesn't matter what the question is, Jesus is the answer. The Bible has a plan of salvation. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God, Romans 3:23, ESV. This indicates that no one can get to heaven because of the sin in our lives. You cannot be good enough or do enough good deeds that will allow you to reach heaven. There is no do more good than bad and be invited into the kingdom of God, for the wages of sin is death, but the free gift of God is eternal life in Christ Jesus our Lord. Romans 6:23, ESV. This statement is final. Sin's payment for the unsaved individual is death. This death is not what some believe to be oblivion and no longer being aware of existence, rather it is eternal separation from God, which is a long time and there are no clocks to say how long that will be. And anyone's name that was not found in the book of life was thrown into the lake of fire. Revelation 20:15, ESV. Jesus said, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes in him should not perish but have eternal life." John 3:16, ESV. Most people, in the past, have heard this scripture. Unfortunately, many today have not. This is God's promise to everyone, that if a person believes that Jesus is the Christ, risen from the dead, and seated at the right hand of God, will be saved. That if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord, and believe in your heart that God has raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For with the heart one believes unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. Romans 10:9 and 10, ESV. God's kindness is intended to lead us to repentance. Romans 2:4, ESV. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If anyone hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him and will eat, or fellowship with him, and he with me. Revelation 3:20, ESV. That door is the door of your heart. Jesus is standing at that door and seeking to come into you. If you will open the door to your heart, he will enter and save your soul from the eternal death that awaits all people who refuse to allow him entrance. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Romans 10:13. If you have never believed that Jesus died, was buried and rose from the grave and asked him to be your Lord and Savior, I ask you to open your heart today and let him be your salvation in life. If you are ready, let me lead you in a prayer of salvation. Please repeat these words to the Father. God, our Father, I admit that I am a sinner and I come to you now with an open heart. I believe that Jesus is the only begotten Son of God and is an equal part of the Godhead. I also believe in God the Holy Spirit, who is also an equal part of the Trinity of the Godhead. 3-in-1. Jesus, I accept you into my heart as my personal Lord and Savior. Please forgive me for the sins I have committed, and I ask that you lead me in my daily life. I request, Jesus, that you guide my every decision and walk with me day by day. Now, according to your word, I believe that I am now saved, and I am a child of God, which grants me acceptance in your kingdom forever. Thank you, Father, for accepting me into your family forevermore. Amen. If you said this prayer and truly believed what you have stated, you have passed from death unto life, and are now a fellow Christian with all the rights afforded to each and every child of the living God. John 1:12, ESV. But to all who did receive him, who believed in his name, he gave the right to become children of God. Congratulations. You are now a brother or sister in Christ. Now do as Jesus said and walk with him daily, talk with him daily, by prayer, and allow him to be your guide in all of your decisions. Amen, and amen.